Fuck up.
Okay, and welcome back to Let's Play Light Crusader. I'm Matt, and you all remember Mike from World of Illusion.
Hey guys, how's everything going?
Yeah, this isn't a two-player game, but to make things a little more interesting, I thought that I might have some guest commentary.
Yeah, and I was bored, and, well, I figured, what the hell.
Yeah.
Oh, I remember this game.
Yeah, you should remember it.
I remember this game. Do you remember? And it's been forever.
Yeah, do you remember anything about it?
Barely.
Oh, the music.
Yeah. Oh, yes, the puzzles. The lovely, lovely puzzles.
The puzzles in this game are easy.
Man, there was one that we had a lot of trouble with.
Yeah.
I remember.
There are a couple that I had some trouble with. Oh, man, these guys suck.
These guys hurt.
Yeah.
They have a shitload of hit points.
Yep. I probably should have gone the other way first.
Oh, well. I was going to say, at least he's not actually shooting you with his crossbow, but then he just did.
Yeah. You jinxed me.
I jinxed you. Oh. Oh, yeah. I remember them cutting them in half. That's funny.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Dude, you're going to die.
Better eat something. I don't have the audio on, but it's pretty funny because when you're about to die, you hear a voice say, "They're going to kill you." I thought the music would be more interesting, and plus I thought it'd be easier to hear your commentary if the game music wasn't up.
Yeah, unfortunately Fusion's crappy and doesn't have audio controls.
Yeah. A key 1 to be precise. So how's everything look? Still synced up?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, once we have that key, we can, we hit that to open up that door.
And more of the lovely slimes.
More slimy things. We don't really have to kill them.
But it's far more fun. Don't you get, like, experience or something from killing stuff?
Nope, no experience in this game.
Yeah.
But you get items and stuff like that.
The door's locked.
Yeah, we don't have the right key for that door.
Ah.
Or that door. We have the right key for this door.
Absolutely no indication at all which which door goes with which key.
Yep. Oops, I messed up. This is a common pressure point puzzle. Gonna be a lot of these in this game.
Luckily, with this game, it's, really easy to reset the puzzle.
Yep, just leave the room and come back. Of course, sometimes the enemies respawn.
On your first three things of magic.
Yep. Okay, allow me to briefly explain the magic system. You go into the subscreen and there's air magic, fire magic, earth magic, and water magic. And by itself, it's some sort of weak damaging magic. And you can combine them for other effects. Like a shield, turn undead, thunder, fire wind. One of them heals you. Yeah. Oh, that by itself heals.
Yeah.
And guardian, that like makes a little fairy that comes out and protects you from taking damage. And all of them together is judgment, which basically hurts all the enemies on the screen a little bit. And we can go back this way.
A very long time.
And this is a jumping puzzle, which can be a little tricky since the isometric perspective isn't completely intuitive.
Yeah, we just gotta go with the shadow.
Yeah. Okay, that was a maximum life, which is basically like a heart container in a Zelda game. My max life is now 110. Ow.
Oh, that sucks.
Ow.
That sucks too.
Oh, can't jump over that. Okay, this is a guy who was captured by the evil forces in this game, and he's sporting one hell of a mullet there. Thank you. I had almost given up all hope of ever being rescued. I was captured and brought here by men dressed in black. Be careful, this place is full of demons and traps. And that's all he has to say.
No free stuff.
No, you don't get stuff for rescuing people. Oh, that's a healing fountain.
Yay.
You know that there's a level in Quake that actually has, like, a healing pool in it?
Really?
Yeah, it's like a pool of water, and when you go in it, it just it gives you 25 health. And if you stay in there a little while, it keeps healing you.
Hmm. Never knew.
It's in, like, the last mission or whatever. The last scenario. Okay, this is a very simple puzzle. All we have to do is flip all these lights on, and that opens up this blue portal. Okay, that's another pendant. I explained in the last game, but since Mike doesn't know, that revives you if you die.
Uh-huh. At least I was going to ask that.
And there's a cat sitting here, and when you talk to it, this is the only place in the game where you can actually sell items that you have.
Really?
Like, I could sell bananas for 10 gold, and so on. I don't want to sell. Don't want to sell anything now, though.
So you can't sell stuff when you go back to town?
Nope. The shopkeepers don't sell stuff. Oh, goody. Shitty. It's a boss.
It's the first boss of the game.
Remember this guy?
I do remember this guy.
Fairly easy.
No, we had a little bit of trouble with him the first time we played him.
Oh, the first time, yeah.
We weren't sure what to attack.
Well, it's pretty obvious that you attack the eyeball. Of course, sometimes the eyeball doesn't pop out and you have to try to kill those balls. This guy has a lot of hit points and I'm not doing much damage to him either. Just 4 points of damage per hit.
Yeah, 9. One more fire.
Damn, shitload of fire. Good god. I'm probably full now.
Pretty close.
I'll just die already.
You're not feeling too hot.
I'll be fine. If I can just beat this guy, it heals me all the way.
Hmm.
It's hard to believe this is a treasure game. It's so different from everything else that Treasure ever did.
Yes, it is.
Oh yeah, cheese. I think that cures poison or something.
Cheese.
The lessons you learn from video games. Cheese cures poison.
Filet always gives you friggin' full health.
I think the filet gives you like 60 or something. The steak gives you 100.
Wow.
This part of the game really isn't very interesting, unfortunately.
Yeah. Well,
we get into some pretty cool puzzles later on. Okay, out of my way. Fucking worms. Okay, I've got this guy on the ropes. There we go.
And he explodes like always.
Of course.
Well, I guess he did like shoot out fire and stuff, so I guess that kind of makes sense.
Video game lesson number 2. When things die, they explode.
Almost always.
And that would be the second key that we need. Let's see. No, I can't jump up there, I just gotta avoid this fire. Ow. Red potion. That basically heals you a whole bunch. And we need to go back this way.
Are there other color potions?
There's a blue potion that heals you a little bit, I think. Mm. Okay, if we fall in the water, it's going to blow us back like that.
Yeah, I remember this.
Which means we need to jump on these platforms. Fudgicles. You know, I bought a $6 milkshake today.
Really?
Yeah.
Was it any good?
Well, I don't know if that motherfucker was worth $6, but it was damn good. I got it at Maggie Moo's, that place in the mall.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I was wondering if they actually had anything good. It looked like they just had, like, cookies and shit.
No, they have ice cream.
Oh, yeah?
That's what they are. They are an ice creamery. Bread and a sack of gold.
So it was actually $6, huh?
Yep.
That's pretty crazy.
I just asked for a large. I didn't know how much it cost, and it ended up costing $6.
Yikes.
It was huge, though. The trick to beating this thing is to just stand right here. His arm can't get you.
For some reason.
Yeah. Okay, we're about out of time, so we'll see you next time on Let's Play Light Crusader.
Later, guys.